Hello everyone, and hope you are all doing fine on this special time of this pandemic. Our next guest this September is Bernadette Pimenta. She is an educator and a social activist and committed to the upliftment of women and children. She is the ambassador of the Indo-Global Social Service Society Delhi. She is the founder and the vice chairperson of Sevadham, principal of Garden School Child Enrichment Programs, the chairperson of Snehalaya, the Mumbai coordinator of World Community for Christian Meditation. These are just a few of the organizations that she has dedicated her life to. She has, to her credit, a long list of organizations that she is a part of and at very respectable positions. She's got some very, very commendable work to her credit, which might take me a very, very long time to mention, but extremely commendable all the same. She has spent the last 40 years empowering, rehabilitating, counseling, educating children and women in prisons across Maharashtra, helping the demarginalized and the poor, no matter the caste or the creed. The only thing that she believes in is humanity. Along with a whole lot of awards and recognition, she is also the winner of the NGP Social Activist of the Year in 2017. She is also privileged to have met the beautiful Saint Mother Teresa on two occasions. She is proud to be an East Indian, and it is our privilege to have her as our next guest on Mumbai Chahiye. So make sure you tune in to hear the journey of this grand lady, Bernadette Pimenta, on 28th September at 8 p.m. on Me East Indian, the official YouTube channel of the East Indian community. Presenting Cuisine, the authentic homemade East Indian kitchen from the house of Talato. Order kara Indial, Sarpatel, Rotia, Fugias, Tongue Roast, Moil, and Wedding Pickle. Order karawala call kara Talato Gore 98212-82616. To place your order, call Talato Gore on 98212-82616. Difanso Gore's TG Hospitality presents Balle Balle Tandoor, delicious Punjabi food. To place your order, call on 97693-75555 and 99300-20313. Free home delivery. Difanso Gore's TG Hospitality. For authentic Chinese food, presenting the Chinese man. To place your order, call on 99300-20312. 99300
20313 free home delivery.
Hello everyone, and hope you are all doing fine in this time of the pandemic. Please do take care of yourselves. It's time to introduce our next guest on Mumbai Che Hire. This September, we have Miss Bernadette Pimenta. Let me tell you a little about her. She's an educator and a social activist, and she works towards the upliftment of the children and women. And if I can go on and on, but that would be an injustice if I would miss out on something. So we will let Bernadette take it from here. So Bernadette, thank you and welcome to Mumbai Che Hire, and thank you very much for joining us here. I was totally in awe of the moment I walked in and the lady by herself. So Bernadette, please let's start off by telling our audiences and as to how your journey started. And what actually, you know, where did that come from to get into this beautiful field of being a social activist and an educator?
Yes, Ashwin, you are virtually taking me down memory lane. So I'll go back to about more than 50 years.
Okay.
When I entered the portals of St. Xavier's College.
Okay.
When I set foot in the quadrangle, I looked to the left just by chance, and I saw a board which said, God's service in man's service.
Okay.
And believe me, Ashwin, that board is still indelibly etched in my heart and mind. And I decided to dedicate my life to God and society. All the exposures I got in St. Xavier's College were absolutely inclusive. I still remember our trip to the tribal areas, the Katkaris, where we worked for the upliftment of the tribals.
Okay.
And so many other experiences which the college offered us really ensured that we were good human beings. Later on, when I launched in the field of education, I enjoyed training my students for elocution and dramatics. And Abraham Lincoln definitely inspired me. To quote him in one of his speeches, with malice towards none, with charity for all, with firmness in the right, as God gives us to see the right. Okay, I won't continue the speech now. Okay.
Okay.
Then I read a lot about Swami Vivekananda, and his words always echo in my ears.
Yes.
He said, in this world, take always a position of giver. Give everything and look for no return. Give love, give help, give service. Give every little thing you have, but don't look for barter.
And then, inspiration.
Yeah. And then of course, Bapuji, Mahatma Gandhi. All right, be the change you want to see. His simplicity of life.
Absolutely.
And then Dr. Usha Mehta, who walked the talk with Bapuji. She was a great woman. I've shared the stage, the platform with her on one or two occasions. And all the great inspirational models that I've had the good fortune of meeting, interacting with. Then later on, I'm very grateful to Cardinal Simon Pimenta, Cardinal Ivan Dias, and of course now to Cardinal Ozzy Gracious. They have encouraged me a lot in several of my endeavors. I've been on several archdiocesan committees and commissions. And when they had the first national consultation of women leaders in the church in India, I was invited to be a participant.
Okay.
When I heard Mother Teresa was the chief guest, I was just waiting to have a close interaction with this great woman whom I am inspired, I'm inspired by tremendously. To my good fortune, I was requested to be responsible for her requirements for the whole day. And after that session, we had a very close conversation. The photograph there will reflect it. And I mentioned to her what was my mission and vision for the poor and the marginalized. She listened to me very intently, didn't say much, just listened to whatever I had to say. And in conclusion, she just said, just pray about it, and if it's part of God's plan, it will happen. somewhere along the line, I must have forgotten all about it. But then again, the church sent me for the archdiocesan consultation in the year 1990.
Okay.
And I said, I'm going on condition I come back and follow, in all sincerity and commitment, one of the goals of the archdiocese. And I chose for myself the witnessing church.
Okay.
After the consultation, almost immediately, I should say, I just walked into our parish priest room for the Simon Borges. And I just said, Father, I want to start a community center. He didn't even listen to me twice. On a bit of paper, he scribbled something and the Eucharistic celebration was going on.
Okay.
He sent a message. It was announced we were going to start a community center. So once the announcement was made, it was an imperative that I take seriously this commitment
to start
of being a witnessing church.
Okay.
So we first began with a healthcare center, because I feel to be able to serve people, you must be in good health first.
Absolutely.
Good health is very important.
Very important.
So I launched in the healthcare center. I done several courses in Xavier's and homeopathy. So it was initially a homeopathic center. Now it has other streams of medicine incorporated. Then we began with tribal work. And with my tribal work, I must say that I was deeply influenced by Meeta Patkar and by Anuta Ibag.
Okay.
Anuta Ibag is also there. She did a lot for the tribals in postpartum. And I had the good fortune of knowing her fairly closely. Then from there on, Cardinal Pimenta requested me to add one more service, which was a prison ministry. So that came along. Then we had interfaith meetings in the church, in a temple, in the synagogue, on people's rooftops.
Okay.
Okay. In our garden.
Yeah.
And even in the Marthama church. All right. Then we've had over 100 of them over the last 29 years approximately. Okay. So then from then on, there was no stopping me. I just move from one to the other, and as I look back, Ashwin, it is very incomprehensible to me how I have engaged in all these interventions. So it's been a very interesting journey, and I am extremely grateful to God for His divine hand in all this.
I believe you also are the principal of Garden School.
Right. So right. After I was a teacher and a college lecturer for several years, a lot of people told me, what on earth are you doing? Start your own school. Okay, but I didn't want a regular kind of a school.
Okay.
I wanted something different. I wanted to give children a holistic approach to education. I wanted to give them values for the world of today and tomorrow. And that's how I began with the Child Enrichment Program. So I've had students coming here from 3 plus to 15 plus almost.
Okay.
And I can see how they have really shaped up, how they have been molded in Garden School, and how they are making a significant contribution to society. And this I can tell because yesterday was Teacher's Day.
Yes.
And I had dozens and dozens of greetings all over. And that is so satisfying.
Absolutely.
That they have really grown up to be students of character, charism, commitment, and compassion.
Okay, so Bernadette, who are the people who have influenced you? They have motivated you to, you know, to take up something like this, and you know, and pursue it, you know, relentlessly. I'm sure there must have been some very good, great people that you always looked up to, and you know.
Yes, okay. I think here I've got to express my gratitude to my mom and dad.
Okay.
My mom was a very simple person who just loved people.
Okay.
My dad was a very thorough disciplinarian.
Okay.
And biblical quotations and quotations for daily living.
Okay.
Right? He always said, eat to live, don't live to eat. He said, waste not, want not.
Okay.
Vanity is vanity, all is vanity. Okay. Biblical quotation, what is the profit a man if he gains the whole world but suffer the loss of his own soul?
Absolutely.
Of course, as a child, I must have dismissed all these.
Yeah.
But these things gain relevance a lot later.
Yeah.
Okay. And when my dad told me that my great-grandfather was a village panchayat Village Patil.
Patil.
The village, not the panchayat, yeah, sorry, yeah, the village Patil.
Patil,
okay.
There.
I said, I have to do something to cherish his memory.
Okay.
All right. And so I thought it would be an excellent thought, an excellent idea, if I get into some kind of activism which would involve community upliftment.
Okay.
Especially those on the periphery of society, the poor, the marginalized, those who have suffered gross violations, human rights, whatever. So I think the family atmosphere was very conducive.
Okay.
When I used to go on a tribal camp every fortnight, ring the bell, come home, my mom used to open the door and she says, "What is this? You're looking like a monkey." Okay. Because I had a tan.
Okay.
Used to work in the sun the whole day, kind of those kabilas.
Yeah.
Interacting with the Katkari tribes, which was such a rewarding experience. And can you believe, Ashwin, I've even given injections indiscriminately.
Okay.
I wouldn't dare to do it now. Because all the tribals feel much better, they're given a shot.
Okay.
Then later on, I had a very good fortune. It was just providential that I met lovely people.
Okay.
Lovely people on several occasions that have really inspired me, touched a chord somewhere, and the greatest of them all that I mentioned earlier was Mother Teresa.
Absolutely. You are a very lucky person.
Absolutely.
And all those who have met her.
Yes.
In fact, I have met her too, but I have that was when I was in my teens.
I got a very faint idea
where we must have gone on stage and then done some dancing and all for her.
Like,
and
yes,
she was there watching us. And since I was at St. Xavier's Vilepale and you had Shishu Bhavan just behind and she was Mother Teresa's home, you know.
Very true.
The Sisters
true.
Of Charity, Missionaries of Charity were there.
Yes,
so
we
were lucky to have seen her, not met her in person, but at least seen her.
Yes, so she has just been a remarkable woman.
Yeah.
You know, so diminutive in stature, but so firm,
absolutely
persuasive
yes.
on her perceptions of things around. Okay. And writing to each other, she responding very promptly, me going to Kolkata to interact with her, and then this great occasion when I was given the responsibility of looking after her. That was an honor, I think, that the church bestowed on me. I was very, very delighted about that.
We were lucky to have pictures with her. We didn't know what was the camera at that age.
Then of course, when I went to Delhi, I met the Prime Minister, Indira Gandhi, at that time.
Okay.
When I went to the north, I interacted with Vijayalakshmi Pandit.
Okay.
All right. Then of course, Meena Patkar.
Yes.
You know,
okay.
Meena Patkar. I have no words to express.
A lovely lady. Yes.
How great she is. How committed she is to the tribals. I still remember our meeting in Manibeli, well past midnight, with lanterns. The meeting would go on right into the small hours of the morning. That woman is. An undaunted spirit.
Absolutely.
Okay. No difficulty, no obstacle. She converts all the problems into opportunities, I think.
Absolutely.
You see?
Yes.
So she's definitely impressed me a lot. I still remember traveling the river Narmada on a boat with her.
Okay.
It's a swollen river. All of us are traveling on that boat.
Okay.
And the boat had a hole in it. And Medha is taking a Bisleri bottle and emptying all the water into the river, and we were so scared we would all drown, to be honest with you. She was undeterred in the face of these problems.
Okay.
So interacting with people like this, you know, each one is so inspirational in their own way.
Yeah.
When no difficulty is too difficult for them to surmount.
Absolutely.
It's been amazing. It's been
You've been
amazing.
Lucky lady to interact with all these people.
And I'm really grateful to God for His divine intervention everywhere. I thought I wouldn't come back alive after that Narmada journey. So it was a God saving grace, I think.
Yeah.
Presenting Cuisine, the authentic homemade East Indian kitchen from the house of Talato. Order kara Indial, Sarpatel, Rotia, Fugias, Tongue Roast, Moil, and wearing pickle. Order karawala call kara Talato Gore 98212 82616. To place your order, call Talato Gore on 98212-82616. Difanso Gore's TG Hospitality presents Balle Balle Tandoor, delicious Punjabi food. To place your order, call on 97693-75555 and 99300-20313. Free home delivery. Difanso Gore's TG Hospitality. For authentic Chinese food, presenting The Chinese Man. To place your order, call on 99300-20312, 99300-20313. Free home delivery.
Okay, so Bernadette, tell us something about what your future plans are going to be like. You're doing so much, and I'm sure you got a lot of things on your mind.
All right.
For the future, per se.
Okay. Yeah. Again, to go to the future, I'll have to go a little bit delving into the past.
Please do.
Okay.
Please do.
Like, I believe that one has to have motivation, a goal, and work towards that goal.
Very true.
Okay.
Okay.
I decided to finish all my degrees, post graduation, etc., everything. Before I touched 25-30.
Okay.
Then I planned to launch a garden school somewhere thereabouts. It just happened.
Okay.
At 40, I planned to start my own NGO around there. It just happened.
Lovely.
Okay. At 50, I wanted to convert my old-fashioned traditional classes to a value-based program for children. That was to celebrate my silver jubilee, the teaching profession.
Okay.
Now, between 60 and 70, I'm at the threshold of 70 now, all right? And I am celebrating the golden jubilee of my teaching profession.
Okay.
So, I have to make a contribution to the field of education. And my NGO, Sevadham, will complete 30 years next year.
Okay.
So, I'm just trying to see how I can engage in something which will be an educational endeavor with something for the marginalized.
Okay.
So hopefully I got the right kind of people, got people who are sincerely motivated, who are approaching my perception, the vision and the mission, but I need the finances.
Okay.
And I know if it's God's work, it will happen, as Mother Teresa assured
me. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Then I also want to hand over. Ashwin, I believe in principle, when one is on the threshold of 70, one has to hand over. No power, no position, nothing of that sort. We have to get fresh blood injected.
Absolutely.
Because the youngsters today, I am really impressed. The youngsters have a mission, have a vision. They are given the right direction in life. And I always wanted to identify a student of St. Xavier's College and the students of garden school.
Okay.
So I have got them both.
Okay.
And they both are in their 20s and they have already made a significant contribution to society. Wow. And they are both prepared
to take over. Lovely.
So that is another God-given gift to me.
Absolutely.
And wherever I am, I have to hand over, I believe, in principle.
Yeah.
Because we can learn a lot from the youngster. They have so much to offer us.
So Bernadette, what are your thoughts on the Mumbai Gautam Panchayat? The reason why, how we are here and we are sitting and talking across this table.
Right.
Yeah.
When Gleason introduced me to it, I was absolutely impressed. Because it's just a decade old. And I am only 2 years old in the MGP.
Yeah, even I am just 2 months old.
And it was a very heartwarming experience to attend the two meetings at Hotel Amion. And I find that Gleason and Alfie and Walter are really committed to building up the community, getting them all together in love and service. And now it's reaching thousands of East Indians across the globe.
Yeah, thanks to the
because of the pandemic, all right?
Yes.
And the arenas that they have spread out into, music, dance, out on spirituality.
Absolutely.
Okay. Yeah. Culinary art.
And lots more to come.
And a lot more to come. Okay. So I'm extremely impressed. But since I'm a very inclusive person, I feel that we belong to a very rich cultural and spiritual heritage.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I think we need to get people across other spiritual affiliations to be a part of at least one annual program in each Gautam.
Okay, in each Gautam.
Yes, because we had a celebration for one festival in the Kolbad Gautam.
Okay.
And I saw how well that went off. This was years ago.
Okay.
Okay. The police commissioner was there, if I'm not mistaken, about 20 odd years ago, you know. So this could be experimented on, because I'm absolutely impressed by the rich mosaic and the diversity of this great motherland.
Yeah.
Okay. And I think we need to also engage in environmental issues.
Okay.
Because this beautiful planet of ours has been gifted by God to us, and we need to preserve, promote and enhance the environment.
We aren't taking
care
of it.
Which is primarily God's gift to us. Okay.
We aren't taking
care
of it.
But we are seriously desecrating the environment.
Yes, absolutely.
Very many times. Okay. Then we have a mandate from Christ to work for the poor and the marginalized.
Okay.
When you have gross violations of human rights. So I think we need to engage in building God's kingdom of justice, peace and love.
Well said. Okay, so Bernadette, finally, as we conclude, we would want you to give a message out to whoever's watching, and the reason why we have you here, because you are a great inspiration. From if they ever Google and find out about you, they'll get to know so much. Unfortunately, I have not been able to bring that all out. I'm sure you should please go ahead and Google Bernadette Pimenta and you will get the works. Okay. So what do you want to tell our youth and our children and the adults also, if they when they're watching us, and what is your message to all of us?
To all our dear friends, sons and daughters of the soil.
Yeah, that's what they call us.
Yes,
sons and daughters of the soil.
There is so much we can engage in to build a better world, to build a harmonious world. And we only need to commit ourselves to a cause and thank God for all the graces and the blessings He has bestowed us with. So I think it's an imperative that all of us in a small capacity can reach out to others. Like Mother Teresa always said, do small things with great love. That's enough.
Absolutely.
Okay. The quotation that I hold dear to my heart by Mother Teresa is, where there is faith, there is love. Where there is love, there is peace. Where there is peace, there is God. Where there is God, there is no need.
Okay.
So I think we need to also make God the center of our lives. We need to believe in His infinite mercy. We need to believe that He is around us during the pandemic, out of the pandemic, in all the distressing, difficult, happy moments of our life. He is there intervening in just everything. So in conclusion, I just like to say, when you look back, thank God. Look ahead and trust Him. Look around and find Him. Look within, find Him and see Him. We are all made in His image and likeness, and He dwells within us. I'm extremely grateful to the NGP for having me on this program. And I think, Ashwin, you have to get Gleason, Alfie and Walter on this show, okay? Because when first met Gleason, I was really inspired. In a decade, to be making such rapid strides and to have spread their wings across the globe in so very many arenas, something has definitely stirred their inside.
Correct.
Okay, so they have also had some soul-stirring experience which has enabled them to make a commitment to the community. I'm learning about the community because of Gleason and Alfie. And I am overwhelmed with gratitude for knowing more about the community, even though I'm in the twilight of my years, on the threshold of 70. Okay, there's no end to learning. So as a community, we have to keep on learning.
Absolutely.
And I think we have to encourage our children and youth to be engaged in educational endeavors. I'm not referring to a degree, not to a paper qualification. I'm referring to a holistic, integrated education. Education which will contribute to enhancing their emotional quotient and their spiritual quotient. That will definitely make them good citizens of our country and good citizens of the world. So thank you, Ashwin. Thank you so much.
Thank
God
you.
Bless you.
Thank you, Bonnet.
And thank you, Nathan, too.
And what we can do is, you know, in case if you are interested to, you know, you want to join, you want to help Bernadette in all her goals, you know, pending goals and or the current work that she's doing as a social activist, as an educator, we would love to share your coordinates, as in not your number, but we will share your email ID and, you know, they can get in touch with you.
We did a night out in Bandra last year.
Okay.
So my volunteers were from Bandra.
Okay.
Okay. So we go every winter distributing blankets to the poor and the marginalized, living on the streets of Mumbai. And last year, Bishop Alvin joined us, Bishop Pathol joined us.
So yes, if you want to join her in all this great work that she does, please you get in touch with her. We will be sharing the coordinates at the soon after this, we end the interview. So thank you very much, and thank you, Bernadette. And just to tell you, these gentlemen, Gleason, Alfie and Walter, they were the first two on my list, but they prefer to be behind the scenes.
I know.
That's how they would want to be.
They're extremely unassuming.
Yeah.
And that's why I appreciate all the inroads they have made, you know, to get this MGP growing.
So they always say, it's not about them, it's not about me, it's all about the people.
And that's what I appreciate them very much.
Thank you.
Presenting Cuisine, the authentic homemade East Indian kitchen from the house of Talato. Order kara Indial, Sarpatel, Rotia, Fugias, Tongue Roast, Moil, and Wearing Pickle. Order karawala call kara Talato Gore 98212-82616. To place your order, call Talato Gore on 98212-82616. Difanso Gore's TG Hospitality presents Balle Balle Tandoor, delicious Punjabi food. To place your order, call on 97693-75555 and 99300-20313. Free home delivery. Difanso Gore's TG Hospitality. For authentic Chinese food, presenting The Chinese Man. To place your order, call on 99300-20312, 99300-20313. Free home delivery.